Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, today we're going to show you how to build this image accordion, and not only does it pop up images, but when you hover over them, if you want to, you can have some text appear. And just click on the one you want to open, hover over it, got the text there. And there's no plugins involved with this today. This is just using the inbuilt features of the Divi theme. Really easy to do, and that's a nice little feature to have on your site. So let's get started. I'm going to enable the Visual Builder. Let's go down to where we want to work and add our accordion module. Divi comes as standard with all the light gray modules here, and there's plenty of them. The blue ones here from Divi Supreme Modules, which is a premium plugin addition to the Divi theme, and it's absolutely awesome. And here's some more regular Divi ones down here. You also get another dozen or so if you've got WooCommerce installed that'll help you arrange your products. So I'm going to use the accordion one right here, simply left click on it. I'm going to delete the second one that's right there. And here's our little first accordion right here. Let's go in there, we'll get this one done, and then we can arrange the others. Now, if you just want an image accordion with no title and no content, simply delete the title and content, and we'll just use an image. But we're going to use a little hover effect on this today. So I'll just call this one boat, because I'll use a boat image for it. Don't particularly want to link it to anywhere. If you do, this is where you put it. And best practice, if you're linking to your own site, leave it in the same window. If you're linking to somebody else's site or off your own site, open it in a new tab so yours stays open. Okay, background, this is where the image actually comes in. So what I'm going to do is go over to image. You've got color, gradient, image or video. And we'll select our image. And I'll use that little boat one again. Okay, so we've got our image in there. There's a little bit of text. And before I start playing around with the hover effects on this, I'm actually going to go to the design and make it the height that we actually want it. So I've gone over to design tab, going to go to sizing. I'm going to go down to height. Just pull it back and back and back until it's the size that you want it, which is something like that. You can see the image start to come in when it expands too much, so something around there. Whatever works for you. Now, it's a good idea, hit the little mobile icon just above it. If it's not there, once you hover over it, it will appear. And just check it on tablet. Tablet, we want to change the height. And again, make it the size that's going to work on a tablet, because you can have different for tablet and mobile. And the same for mobile. Actually, that looks okay on mobile. Back to desktop. So we're good to go there. Great. Now let's go back into the content and we'll start playing with the hover effects. So I'm going to go back down into background. Remember, we're just in our first accordion module setting here. I'm going to give it a background color. It doesn't matter what color you give it. It's entirely up to you. So I want it to, when we hover over it, darken down a bit, and we'll lighten up the text so we can read the text and title. So I'm going to use a black, but I don't want it all the way black. I'm going to take it down about 75% with the opacity slider there. Now you notice we can't see it, which is fine because we haven't set the image to blend. So what I'm going to do is go over to my image, going to go down right at the bottom, you'll find background image blend. Now for desktop version, I'll leave it just on normal. We can hit the little arrow up here and get a desktop when your mouse is not on it. And a hover when your mouse is on it. I'm going to flip to hover over here. I'm going to flip this to to one of the other ones. Multiply will probably do. As you can see, that's really darkened that down now, but that's only going to happen when we hover over it. And they've got some fantastic effects. If you use these, just experiment with them, you can really get some great effects going. But I'll just use the multiply on the hover today. So that's a little too dark. Let's go back into our color. And I'll take that opacity down even a little bit more so we can see a little bit more of the image, but it's fairly dark, so when I lighten up that text, we'll be able to read it. So that looks fairly good. Let's go over to our design, go down to our title text. You can give it whatever color you want, and you can have different colors for open and closed versions. We're looking at the open version here. I'm going to have mine both white, as you can see. There it is. I think I'll capitalize that too. Great. Now let's just close that up and we'll pop down to the regular text, body text. I'm going to make that white. And we can see that nicely. So let's go back to our content and flip it back to desktop mode. There we go. But I don't want to see this text at all until we hover over it. So what we can do is go back to our body text again. And where it says body text color, I set it to white. Again, hit the little arrow. And for the hover state, we'll leave it white. And for the regular desktop state, I'm going to make it transparent. That way it's only going to appear when we hover over it. If I hit the hover state, make sure we got that white color in there. Desktop state, hover state. Great, well that should work. Well, we've got our first one done here. So let's duplicate it and put a few more in. So I'm going to save the changes. There's our first one right there. Duplicate it as many times as you want. Okay, I'm going to delete those because I've just realized something. I don't want any gap between them. So let's just get rid of those two. We'll go back into this one. I'm going to go to design and then spacing. I'm going to put a zero in the margin. And that's margin on the bottom. And also, I want to make sure there's no border, because by default, the accordion usually has a little border on it. Yeah, border width one. So I'm going to take that down to zero, and we'll try this again. Let's duplicate, little two squares, left click. That's better. They're buffered up on top of each other there. Now, if you wanted to reduce the size of the actual gap between the top of the writing and the bottom, you could go in, we'll go into the second one here, go to the design, and again in spacing, reduce the padding top and bottom. At the moment, it looks like about 20 pics or so. If you say 10 pics, just put in the 10, it'll put the pics before you. And you can reduce it down smaller if you want to. That's entirely up to you. I'll leave mine on the default. Okay, so let's duplicate it a couple more times. However many images you like to have in your accordion there, and simply go into the next one, swap out the image. Obviously you're going to have different text in each of your pictures. Couple more to go. And last one, we'll test it all out. Got to remove those toggles in a moment, and we can do that globally. Okay, so let's just save this, save the main one. Like I say, we want to probably remove these toggles. And to do that, we can do that globally if we go back in there. Go to our design tab, here's the toggle. open toggle background color close. Well, I don't want to see it either when it's open or when it's closed, so I'm going to put transparent on both of those. And on the icon itself, we'll make that transparent too. And there we go, they've disappeared. Okay, well, let's save this and see what we've got. Obviously, you want to go in and change your titles on those images like I've done over here. Save the draft or publish if you're ready. And exit the Visual Builder. Okay, so there we have it. There's our boat. If we click on the next one, it'll open up. There's the text and the darkening out when we hover over it. Do the same with the next one. And again, we've got the text when we hover over it. Same with the last one. There we go. That's a nice little feature to have on your site. And like I said, you don't have to have any text in here. You can just use it as a simple image accordion by deleting the text and the title. So there you have it. There's how to create an image accordion with text overlay on hover. So I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.